Welcome to another edition of This Is My Architecture. Today, I'm joined by Peter from 3M. Welcome, Peter.
Thanks a lot.
What does 3M do?
Yeah, so 3M's motto is science applied to life. We're a global technology company. A lot of what we do is materials development. So we're making new materials every day to help our customers.
Awesome. And we're going to talk about an architecture. What was the problem that you were trying to solve that required this architecture?
Yeah. So I work in 3M's research and development unit, and I'm a software engineer. My job is to help our scientists accomplish what they're trying to accomplish more fluidly. So get to those novel materials more quickly. That's okay. What this application tries to solve.
All right. Well, let's walk through your architecture.
Yeah.
Where do we start?
Yeah. So if we're talking about one of our material scientists, we have labs in 50 countries across the globe, over 8,000 scientists. That's our primary audience for this application. They interact with this application through the web, so they're using their browser. They authenticate themselves, and then we get a jot back from our authentication provider, and that goes up to our Lambda. So say this user is requesting a material. They want to see the properties of a given material within the system. The very first thing that happens after that request comes through is that we actually go over and we hit our DynamoDB here that's dedicated to determining whether or not they have that access. So within this table, we have UUIDs of each material within the system. We have user IDs associated with that material, and then their access level, so a bit mask that tells us what they're allowed to accomplish with that material.
So really fine-grained access control there. You mentioned UUIDs. Why?
Yeah, so access control is really important for us. 3M thrives on our intellectual property. And one of the things that's really important to us is keeping novel materials secret until they're ready to be patented. And so we need to operate on a need-to-know basis. At the same time, we want our scientists to have as much information as possible to allow them to do their jobs. And so this system is allowing us to do that in a kind of a fail-fast way, very performant.
Awesome. So let's say make it through the traffic light here, or the traffic check. What happens next?
Yeah. So we travel up to our Remix Lambda, and this is a kind of a monolithic node application that handles rendering our user interface and interacting with our data store. So the database we have for this product is a Aurora managed Postgres. That's where all the material data ultimately resides.
Okay. So that's the flow for your scientists, but I see another Lambda here. Why do we have two Lambdas in this workflow?
Yeah, so scientists are not going to be the only audience within our company who want to know more about our materials as they're being developed. So we also have an audience of primarily business analysts who might want programmatic access to this information. So they travel kind of the same path. They go through the same traffic light, as you said, and then they're going to access our database through a GraphQL layer. So this allows us to have a robust contract with those users who might want to access this data in a programmatic way and gives them an interface that's really powerful and lets them, you know, query it as they want to.
Cool. That's a really cool architecture where you're using two different data or two different ways to access the same data to serve different user bases.
Yeah, that's right. And it's completely serverless, so we can serve our users across the globe. 3M's a global company. That's incredibly important for us.
Well, thank you for sharing your architecture with us today.
Absolutely.
And thank you for watching. This is My Architecture.